To some extent, however, all equipment is limited to the installed power and lift capability, and the limits installed equipment places on useful payload. The most extensive armor is placed around the pilot's engines, transmission, and fuel tanks. Fuel lines, control cables, and power for the tail rotor may also be shrouded by Kevlar armor. The most heavily armored helicopters are attack, assault, and special forces helicopters. In transport helicopters, the crew compartment may or may not be fully armored, a compromise being to give the passengers Kevlar lined seats but to leave the compartment for the most part unarmored. Survivability is enhanced by redundancy and the placement of components to protect each other. For example, the Black Hawk family of helicopters uses two engines and can continue to fly on only one under certain conditions. The engines are separated by the transmission and placed so that if attacked from any one flank, the engine on that flank acts to protect the transmission and the engine on the other side from damage. Aviation electronics, or avionics, such as communication radios and navigation aids, specialized avionics, such as electronic countermeasures and identification friend-or-foe systems, are military-specific systems that can also be installed on military helicopters. Other payload emission systems are installed either permanently or temporarily, based on specific mission requirements, optical and IR cameras for scout helicopters, docking sonar and search radar for anti-submarine helicopters, extra radio transceivers and computers for helicopters used as airborne command posts. Armor, fire suppression, dynamic and electronic systems enhancements are invisible to casual inspection, as a cost-cutting measure some nations and services have been tempted to use what are essentially commercial helicopters for military purposes. For example, it has been reported that the PRC is carrying helicopter regiments with the civilian version of the MiL-B-17. 1. These helicopters without armor and electronic countermeasures will function well enough for training exercises and photo opportunities with